Today, I'm going to teach you the Mudbox Autodex software. It is a software where you can add more detail, high detail to the polygonal character. Let me tell you what digital sculpting and traditional sculpting is. There are seem to be a 3D model. You may be a three-dimensional model who has been chasing edges, vertices and polygons and is ready for transition to digital sculpting. For a traditional sculptor who has been elbow deep in clay, rubber, plaster and wax for years and is curious about digital sculpting, we encourage you to keep looking through this course because we believe that you will find the information and encouragement that you seeking within this course. There are two main goals that I'm going to take you through this course. You digital sculpting with the digital sculpting. Autodesk Mudbox is the fundamental of art of sculpture as applied for the digital sculpting. Well, the primary focus of this course is going to be a sculpting with the Mudbox. In addition to sculpting, there are two workflows. The first workflow goes something like Maya, Mudbox, Maya. Maybe you can replace it with other 3D program, other 3D application like Softimage XSI, and there's a 3ds Max, you can say. In this scenario, a low resolution model is imported into Mudbox, sculpted, and then the sculpted detail is exported back into Maya, where the sculpting details are maintained with the combination of bump, normal, and displacement map, along with the painted textures. The second workflow is it will be viewed in chapters next chapter. It can be a 3D Max Mudbox, 3 metal painting Mudbox. To get an idea what you can expect from this course, the following are the contents in each chapter. For beginner, this course is pretty good. Lesson 1, lesson number 1, lesson number 2, lesson number 3. There are total 7 lessons in this course. First lesson is concept of sculpting. Second is Mudbox introduction. Lesson number 3 is face sculpting. Lesson number 4 is figure sculpting. Lesson number 5 is painting a model. Lesson number 6 is creating maps. Lesson number 7, the final one, is saving and exporting. Well, let me tell you about lesson number 1. It is the concept of sculpting. We will cover the concept. Well, there are basically two concepts of sculpting. You can say traditional sculpting and digital sculpting. In this today's modern world, we are going to be a digital, so we are going to learn a digital sculpting where we can create a sculpture as it is. We can create it with the traditional style. Well, about lesson number 2, we will introduce the Mudbox, a brief introduction where we are going to see user interface of the software. We can learn the tools, we can learn the workspace, we can learn how to use the workspace and the tools of the software. Well, apart from that, lesson number 3, where we are going to learn face sculpting, and another one, lesson number 4, is figure sculpting. About face sculpting, let me tell you, for the Mudbox, you must or you should be familiar with Maya, Max, or any other 3D software. You should know how to create a polygonal model, how to do a modeling in 3D software. You should have the basic knowledge of modeling a character. Lesson number 3 and 4 will introduce you about the sculpting of the face and figure. What main part is that you should be familiar with the modeling techniques. You should know the basic of the modeling. Apart from that, there's a lesson number 5 where we can paint, we can learn the painting of a model, where we can paint the model, paint the character with so many advanced tools that Mudbox, Autodesk Mudbox provides. It's very highly advanced tools where we can do painting with easy step. There's lesson number 6 where we are going to use some maps on the character for the making it a very deep detail of the character. Basically the maps we use for the detailing of the character. There are two basic maps, and you can say normal maps and extracted maps. So we are going to cover those things in lesson number 6. Well, apart from lesson number 6, there is a last software. Lesson number 7 is where we're going to learn how to save those characters, save those work, and how to export it for next thing, where you can export it for software like Maya, Max, or any other 3D software. Well, this is how we are going to cover all those things in our course. Well, I'll see you in the next lecture. Thank you. I hope you enjoy it.